finding yourself in an uncomfortable seated position, knees are in line with the hips, palms open to the sky on the thighs, maybe sitting up onto a block or blanket if needed. Bringing hands together at heart center, the spine is straight, the back of the neck as long as the chin tucks to the chest. Taking a moment for yourself before this practice begins. Blinking the eyes open, gazing down at the fingertips, releasing the hands, rolling over, we'll meet in a tabletop position, wrists under shoulders, knees underneath the hips, making our way through a few cat-cows, inhaling belly drops, gaze lifts, exhale, tailbone tucks, chin to chest, inhale, belly drops, gaze lifts, exhale, tailbone tucks, chin to chest, inhale, lifting, exhale, chin to chest. Continuing to move through on your own, moving as freely as you like, opening up the spine, getting into the back muscles. Breathing through, allowing the breath to dictate movements from one place to the next. Coming back to a neutral spine and then lowering into a child's pose as the knees come wide, the feet come to touch. We lower the booty to the heels, the arms are out in front of us. The forehead may come to the floor, sinking into the hips and breathing here. On an inhale, rising back up, passing through tabletop position, pressing into hands and feet for a downward facing dog. It's that shape of an upside down V if we're newer to the practice. It's an outer to inner rotation of the palms, a straight spine, hollowing out the belly, drawing navel to spine. On an inhale, coming forward to a plank pose, a high push-up position, wrists under shoulders, lengthen the posture. Exhale, lowering the knees first to the mat, then the chest and chin, keeping the booty in the air, elbows hug torso, shoulder blades together on the back. With an exhale, releasing the pelvis to the floor, we'll find a baby cobra into a cobra dog, pressing into the palms, trying to straighten the arms. The toes are firmly pressing down into the mat. Those legs are engaged. We inhale, exhale, coming back to the floor, passing through a tabletop position and into a child's pose. Inhale, rising back up to downward facing dog. Breathing here. Stepping or walking those feet forward to the top of the mat, finding a halfway up position. The hands may come to the floor or mat. If not, ankles, shins, knees, thighs. Focus is finding a flat lower back, the lumbar region. Thighs are rotating in and back. We're tucking the tailbone. Taking an inhale halfway up. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale halfway up. Exhale, folding forward. Inhaling halfway up, exhale, folding forward, finding your Uttanasana, shaking the head yes and no, rocking side to side, maybe opposite elbows for a little added weight into the posture. Just relaxing, releasing, and then letting those arms hang. Inhaling arms out and up overhead, palms touch. Exhale, releasing, finding Tadasana, mountain pose. Toes touching top of the mat. Inhaling arms up overhead. Exhale, folding forward, Uttanasana. Inhaling halfway up. Exhale, planting hands, stepping back. Plank pose, lowering to a low push-up or chaturanga. Inhaling upward facing dog. Exhaling downward facing dog. 5 breaths here. Finding the Ujjayi breath, we breathe in and out through the nose as that mouth remains closed. We find a soft whisper, that in the back of the throat. Inhalations are just as long as the exhalations. Breathing here. Inhaling to step or float those feet forward between the hands halfway up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhaling, arms rise overhead, palms may touch. Exhale, releasing, Tadasana. Again, inhale, arms rise, palms touch. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, plant those hands, step or float it back. Plank pose, chaturanga, low push-up. Inhaling, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathing here, five nice long ujjayi breaths. Gazing back at those feet, inner thighs have an inward rotation. Stepping or floating those feet forward between the hands on the inhale. Exhale, folding forward. Inhaling, arms rise, palms will touch. Exhale, releasing, Tadasana. Again, inhale, arms rise, palms touch. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhaling, halfway up. Exhale, planting hands, floating back, chaturanga. Inhaling, up dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Breathing here. Pressing down on the thumb mound, the index finger mound. It's an external rotation of the upper arms, the upper biceps. We want those ears in line with the arms. And breathing. Inhale, floating those feet forward between the hands, halfway up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhaling, arms rise, palms will touch. Exhale, releasing, Tadasana, mountain pose. Surya Namaskar B. Inhale, knees bend, arms rise, Utkatasana. Forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, planting hands, floating back. Chaturanga, inhaling up dog. Exhaling downward, facing dog. Inhaling, right foot forward between the hands, warrior one. Arms rise, palms may touch, left foot planted down. Exhaling, planting the hands, stepping it back. Plank pose, chaturanga. Inhaling up dog. Exhaling downward, facing dog. Inhaling, left foot forward between the hands, finding warrior one. Right foot planted down, left knee bends, arms rise, palms may touch. Exhaling, hands frame that foot, moving through the vinyasa. Chaturanga, low push-up. Inhaling, up dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog, finding five breaths here. Breathing in. We start to feel the body open up in the sun salutations, the Surya Namaskars. Bending deeply into the knees, floating those feet forward between the hands, halfway up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhaling, knees bend, arms rise, Utkatasana, chair pose. Exhale, rise to release, Tadasana, mountain pose. Knees bend, arms rise, Utkatasana. Forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhaling, halfway up. Exhale, planting hands, floating back, chaturanga. Inhaling, up dog. Exhaling, down dog. Inhale, stepping right foot forward between the hands, finding warrior one for five breaths. Left foot planted down, reaching through those fingertips as the shoulder blades go down the back. The core is engaged, low ribs to hip points to low ribs. Exhaling, hands frame that front foot, stepping it back. Chaturanga, low push-up. Inhaling, up dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Inhaling, left foot forward between the hands, finding warrior one. Right foot planted down, arms will rise overhead, palms may touch. Squaring hips, left hip back, right hip forward. Blade edge of that back, right foot is firmly pressing down into the mat. Breathing deeply, ujjayi. Exhale, hands frame that foot, stepping it back. Plank pose, chaturanga. Inhaling up dog, exhaling downward facing dog. Breathing in, five nice good deep breaths here. Bending the knees, floating forward between the hands. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhaling, knees bend, arms rise. Chair pose, Utkatasana. holding it here, breathing in, knees squeezing together, sinking into the hips, exhale, rise to release. Inhaling, arms up overhead, exhale, forward fold, inhale, halfway up, exhale, planting hands, floating back, chaturanga, inhaling up dog, exhaling downward, facing dog, breathing in, inhaling right foot forward between the hands, spiral open the arms, finding warrior two, Virabhadrasana 2, it's heel to instep alignment. We're gazing over that right middle finger. If there was a line from the front heel, it would go directly through the instep of that back left foot. Sinking into the hips, shoulder blades together on the back, the arms are in line, breathing in. Inhaling, straighten that right leg, walking the left foot in a pivot or two. Exhaling, we hinge over that straight right leg for Trikonasana, triangle pose. The hand can come to a block, ankle or shin outside of that front foot, maybe even finding the big toes. We inhale that left arm to the sky. 5 breaths. Inhale, rising back up, walking the left foot out a few pivots. We bend into the right knee, coming into extended side angle pose. We can start with the forearm and that thigh as the left arm comes over that left ear, maybe the hand to the inside or outside of that front foot. Breathing in, stretching that side body, gazing underneath that left armpit. Exhaling, left hand to left hip, remaining forward. Walking the left foot in as we bring the right hand underneath that right shoulder. Lifting the left leg, hand is on hip. Maybe inhaling that left arm to the sky. For Ardha Chandrasana, half moon pose. Left foot is flexed, inner thigh is hugging the midline. Working there, maybe working towards the bind. Chapasana, taking hold of that left ankle as we draw the knee into the chest. Pressing out of the right shoulder. Maybe lifting and opening up. Taking an inhale. Exhale like a ninja back to warrior two. Inhaling, reverse warrior. Right knee remains bent. Right arm overhead. Left hand down the leg. Hands frame the front foot. Working here, maybe taking a handstand float if you like. Inhaling up dog, exhaling down dog, meeting there, downward facing dog. Stepping left foot forward between the hands, spiraling open the arms, warrior two. Heel to instep alignment, finding proper alignment, gazing over that left middle finger. The shoulders are stacked over the hips, not coming forward onto the quad or the right leg, but the hips will sink directly down. Inhaling, straighten the left leg, walking right foot in a pivot or two as we exhale into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Left hand can come to the outside of that front foot, maybe a block, maybe big toe. Inhaling, right arm to the sky, trying to straighten that left leg. Breathing in. Inhale, rising up. Right foot may come out a pivot or two as we exhale into extended side angle pose. Left knee bends, forearm can start on that thigh. Right arm over that right ear. Left hand can lower to the inside or outside of that front left foot. Gazing underneath that right armpit, stretching that side body. Exhaling right hand to right hip, walking right foot in, left hand under left shoulder. Lifting that right leg for Ardha Chandrasana, half moon pose. Maybe inhaling that right arm to the sky, the foot is flexed, leg is engaged, hugging the midline. Maybe working toward the quad stretch, Chapasana, bending knee, taking hold of that right ankle with the right hand. Maybe inhaling the gaze to the sky, just an option. Pressing into left big toe mount, kicking foot into the hand. On an exhale, ninja-like, returning to warrior two. Inhaling, reverse warrior, left knee bent, left arm overhead, right hand down, right leg. Exhaling, hands frame that front foot, maybe a handstand float. Planting the hands, lifting that left leg, taking a hop or two. making your way through a vinyasa, inhaling up dog, exhaling down dog, meeting there, breathing in. Inhale, stepping right foot forward between the hands, lowering the left knee to the mat to a kneeling lunge. Hands will come to that right thigh, working there. We want the left knee behind the hip as we inhale those arms to the sky, gazing up, reaching through the fingertips, pressing into right big toe mound, shoulder blades down the back. Breathing in, five breaths. Exhale, releasing hands to that right thigh. Bringing the hands to the inside of that right foot as we walk the right foot out. We press the blade edge, the outside edge of that right foot into the mat. We bring the left hand to the center. We're opening up that right hip. And we inhale that right arm around, bending the left knee, drawing the heel in toward the butt. We can work there, gazing over that right shoulder. Maybe we would lower onto that left forearm, getting deeper into this posture. Opening up that right hip and the left quad simultaneously. Opening the heart to the sky. Releasing out of the bind gently. Coming onto the hands, walking foot to center, framing that front foot. The hands will come to that right thigh. Inhaling left arm to the sky. Exhale to go forward and out, working the twist. Left elbow to the outside of that right thigh. Bringing the arm as far down along that thigh as we can. Hands will come into prayer position, elbows in line, shoulder blades in line, working here. Maybe pressing the ball of that left foot into the mat to lift that left leg. Going deeper, the left hand can come to the outside of that right front foot and the right arm overhead. Again, just an option, taking your practice to wherever it needs to be and breathing there. We'll exhale, hands will come to the inside of that right front foot. We'll walk the right foot out once more. We'll work lizard pose. Hands can be on the palms here. Maybe we come to the forearms, gazing back at the navel, rounding the upper back, hollowing out the belly, drawing right knee into that right shoulder. It's hugging, squeezing in. We're lifting through that left hamstring, working here. Maybe going deeper, we start to work that shoulder under the knee over the shoulder. It's just an option. And maybe we find the arm balance, Kundinyasana. That right leg would extend as that left leg would lift, pointing the toes, strong in the core, breathing, and then exhale, releasing out, stepping right foot back through a vinyasa, plank pose, chaturanga, inhaling up dog, meeting in downward, facing dog, returning to the breath, finding stability here. Inhaling left foot forward between the hands, bringing the hands to that left thigh, right knee's behind the right hip, the knee is lowered. Inhaling the arms overhead, kneeling crescent lunge, maybe even finding a back bend of the posture. Opening the heart to the sky. Pressing into left big toe mound. The back right foot is tucked. Exhaling, hands will release to the mat. Inside of the foot, we walk the left foot out, coming to the outside edge of the foot. The leg is engaged. Right foot comes to center as we inhale that left arm back behind us, trying to take hold of that right ankle. The knee is bent, working there, maybe lowering on the forearm. It's a twisted quad stretch. Left foot remains engaged, protecting that hip, but feeling the opening. Exhaling here, hands release to the mat. They come to the inside of that front foot. Walking the foot to center, hands will come to that left thigh again. Inhaling right arm to the sky. Exhale, we'll go forward and out, taking a twist. Right elbow to the outside of that left thigh. Hands can come into prayer position, working the shoulders in line. Maybe if we'd like to go deeper, the option is to press the ball of that right foot into the mat to lift that knee off the floor, breathing a bit of buoyancy into that right hamstring. Going deeper if you prefer, the option is to bring that right hand to the outside of that left foot. The left arm would come up and over that left ear, similar to extended side angle pose. A deep twist, releasing toxins from the body, massaging those internal organs. Inhaling to lengthen, exhaling to fold deeper. And then exhaling, releasing the hands to the mat, bringing the hands to the inside of that front left foot, coming into lizard pose. We can work on our forearms here. We can walk that left foot out if we need a little extra space. Certainly is welcome. Working on the palms, maybe lowering to the forearms. Maybe working that shoulder under the knee over the shoulder. Hands would come into chaturanga, maybe finding the arm balance, ekapada, kundinyasana. Left leg would extend and lift as that right leg would lift. Balancing the body, looking forward, working there, maybe shooting it back, moving through a vinyasa. Inhaling up dog, exhaling down dog. Breathing and meeting there. Bending the knees, gazing forward, floating forward, maybe lowering onto the butt. We'll bring the feet together as the knees will come wide for Baddha Konasana, bound angle pose. Thumbs will come to inner big toe mounds, opening up the feet like a book. Inhale, rising up, exhale, folding forward. You can give yourself an adjustment by bringing the hands to the elbows to the inner thighs. Breathing here, folding deeper. Inhale, rising up, straightening those legs. Setting up for Dandasana, staff pose. Hands next to hips, feet are flexed, inner thighs are rotating in and down. No rounding in that low back, using a blanket to sit up if you need. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, folding forward, finding the big toes if we can. The knees can bend. Getting deeper, the elbows may come out to the side. Maybe the hands will go beyond the feet. Maybe taking hold of opposite wrists. Inner thighs in and down, getting deeper into this forward fold, breathing into that low back. Inhale, rising up, bringing the hands next to the hips, and then lowering onto the back. The heels are together, the knees are wide. Hands can come to those inner thighs for reclined Supta Baddha Konasana. Just enjoying the breath here for a few moments. Straightening the legs, drawing the right knee into the chest, giving it a hug. Rocking it around a little bit. Then we would bring the ball of that foot to the sky, so the hands will come behind that knee joint or behind the thigh. Left foot is flexed, inner thigh rotating in and down. And then drawing the knee into the chest once more. An exhale, taking a twist. Right knee across the left side of the body. Left hand comes to the outside of that left knee. The right arm out to the side in line with the shoulder, working there. Maybe going deeper. There's an option to take hold of the blade edge of that right foot. That bottom knee, that left knee could bend. And we could take hold of that left ankle with the right hand for a very deep twist there. Exhaling to release right knee into the chest, squeezing it in, and then releasing right leg out to meet the left. Drawing left knee into the chest, giving it a hug, squeezing it around. And then straightening that left leg so the ball of the foot would be able to press up against the ceiling. Hands come behind that thigh or knee joint, pressing the femur away from the body. The shoulder blades are in their sockets on the ground. drawing left knee into the chest and bringing the left knee over the right side of the body, taking that reclined twist. Hand can come to the outside of that left knee with the right hand. Maybe going deeper, there's an option to take hold of the outside edge of that left foot with the right hand. We could also bend that bottom knee, that right knee, drawing the ankle into the butt and using the left hand to take hold of the inside of the ankle. We're gazing over that left shoulder, a very deep twist here. Returning to center, releasing the bind, drawing left knee into the chest, and then exhaling to gently release. Setting up for a few back bends, we'll start with bridge pose, walking the feet in as close to the butt as possible. We want to be able to touch those heels and then pressing palms and forearms down, lifting up through hips and chest, maybe interlacing the hands behind the low back, shoulder blades together, back of the head pressing down to open up the throat, breathing in, and exhaling to gently release, lowering to the floor, knees wide, feet wide, knees together. Once again, pressing down, lifting up, taking another bridge pose, hands behind the low back, shoulder blades together, inner thighs hugging one another. Exhaling to gently release, feet wide, knocking knees together. We can work bridge pose if we'd like to go deeper. Maybe wheel pose, hands up above the shoulders, palms pressed down next to the ears. We inhale, pressing down, lifting up to the crown of the head, elbows in, feet are parallel. Inhaling, pressing down to lift up Urdhva Dhanurasana through the hips and chest. The legs are strong. We're bending the back here, breathing in, trying to lengthen the low back. Exhaling, gently releasing down, just coming to the crown of the head, setting up the posture. And once again, pressing down to lift up. One last back bend. Urdhva Dhanurasana, always working the breath. And on your exhale, gently lowering to the crown of your head and then to the mat. Bringing the hands over the heart, and then the knees into the chest, taking a few rocks, coming up to a seated position, legs are straight. We'll find a forward fold. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, reaching for those feet, maybe the toes, the knees can bend. We're breathing into the low back here, a counter pose for all of those back bends we just worked. Inner thighs in and down, the feet are flexed. Inhale to rise up. Exhale, lowering onto the back. Taking another reclining twist to release that low back. Drawing the knees into the chest and releasing those knees over to the left side of the body. The right arm will come out to the side, gazing over that shoulder. Then bringing the knees back to center. We lift the hips, we scooch the hips over to the left side, 2 to 3 inches, as we drop the knees over to the right side. Finding this reclining twist, gazing over the opposite shoulder. And releasing, drawing knees to center, squeezing them in, giving yourself a hug, maybe a happy baby, taking hold of the inside of the feet or the outside of the feet, kicking the feet into the hands. The low back remains grounded, the shoulder blades are in their socket. Just breathing here to release the low back. And exhale, gently releasing out. The feet come to the corners of the mat. We release the Ujjayi breath. We open the palms to the sky. The arms are alongside the torso, but away from the body. Finding Shavasana, final rest for a few moments. When ready, breathing life into those fingertips and toes. Rocking onto the right side, pressing into the left palm, coming up to that comfortable seated position once again, Indian style, maybe half lotus or full lotus. Hands come along the thighs, palms to the sky, and just taking a moment for yourself to finish your practice. Drawing hands together at heart center, and we say Namaste. The light that lives within me honors and recognizes the light that lives within you.